This is Leon Ding. Leon was a Google engineer working on AI infrastructure until he decided to steal cutting-edge technology for the People's Republic of China. To get his payout, all he had to do was simply copy-paste the code he wanted into Apple Notes, export from Apple Notes to PDF, and walk out of the office to board a flight to Beijing. In Beijing, Leon gave public presentations boasting of his expertise and genius coding capabilities. But his new genius didn't extend to drafting escape plans. Instead of just staying in China to enjoy his new riches, he came back to the United States, where he was promptly arrested. America's top AI experts are sounding the alarm. The future of global power is up for grabs, and the war for the 21st century is ours to lose. While the USA is currently the global leader in AI development, there is growing panic that China's expertise in industrial espionage and high-stake capacity make it probable that China will become the first nation to unlock artificial general intelligence, or AGI. Are we standing on the edge of the abyss? How advanced is Chinese AI in reality? And what is at stake exactly if autocracies unlock AGI before the free world? Welcome to ChinaTalk. If you're new here, we deep dive into geopolitics, technology, and the rising tensions between the US and China. Chapter 1, the state of the AI race. American dominance in AI innovation is driven by a vast, sprawling network of private companies, small startups, and university research labs. The quality of US innovation is so high, in fact, that China's state-of-the-art LLMs are actually built on an American foundation. Starting with an open-source model like Meta's Llama, dozens of Chinese AI companies were able to simply add Mandarin training data, restrict chat outputs to comply with censorship laws, and release a product that gives comparable results to GPT-4 at a fraction of the research cost. Even Mandarin-only chatbots are trained on huge quantities of English-language data from the American nonprofit Common Crawl. SenseTime, for example, can explain the details of mathematical concepts for which no Chinese textbook has thus far been written. So, it's important to keep perspective here. It's mostly irrelevant that ChatGPT won the initial battle, because the race for AGI has only just begun. In order to make the leap from chatbot to human-level intelligence, innovation ecosystems in America and China alike will have to clear three major hurdles. 1. Compute. Compute refers to the high-power computer chips plus the electricity necessary to power those chips. US export controls restrict China's access to the world's best AI processors, but that won't be enough to maintain a lead for long. China's indigenous manufacturing capacity and generous subsidies to Huawei have yielded a processor that is about 80% as good as NVIDIA's chips, while being about 3 times more costly in terms of performance per dollar. These processors require a truly gargantuan amount of electricity. Ever felt your laptop heat up while running too many Chrome tabs? Now try to imagine the amount of power necessary to run an AI smarter than any human being. China ranks number one globally in coal power generation. They have a massive fleet of 55 operational nuclear power plants, with 22 more under construction. And they have mobilized local governments to make massive investments in hydropower, wind turbines, and solar power infrastructure. In power, China is poised to beat the United States easily. No espionage required. 2. Algorithmic efficiency. Algorithmic efficiency refers to using less compute to achieve bigger goals. On the surface, there doesn't seem to be much cause for alarm. Much of China's previous AI research has been focused on intelligent city algorithms and facial recognition, and leading AI research firms have only recently begun to pivot to general intelligence. But the key input for algorithmic efficiency is human ingenuity, and China produces a huge amount of high-quality STEM talent every year. The US, by comparison, relies on importing STEM talent through high-skill immigration, since China's population is 4 times as large as the USA's. Unfortunately, the US immigration system is a bureaucratic nightmare, and limits on the number of high-skill visas will act as a bottleneck on US competitiveness as time goes on. 3. Training data. Current AI models have already chewed up and digested every bit of usable information on the internet, but they're still hungry for more. In order for these models to get smarter, human expertise in every technical field imaginable needs to be documented, digitized, and fed to the machines. If you combine these three inputs, computational power, algorithms, and data, the result is just a file of model weights, a collection of bits and bytes that can be easily saved on a flash drive and shoved in your pocket. And unlike the Manhattan Project, which happened in ultra-secret government labs, American tech companies have long pretended that geopolitics is irrelevant to their business model. The result? The level of security in these AI labs is catastrophically bad, and China knows it. With the help of idiot savants like our friend Leon Ding, China plans to skip the hard work of innovating and jump straight to the finish line. After all, ideas are expensive, but upgrades are relatively cheap. If China can focus all their resources on upgrading stolen ideas, no other country stands a chance. The question becomes, what is at stake if China wins the race? Chapter 2: Consequences of Espionage. In 1939, Albert Einstein wrote a letter to President Roosevelt, warning him that scientists were on the verge of learning how to split the atom. In the course of the last 4 months, it has been made probable to set up a nuclear chain reaction in a large mass of uranium, by which vast amounts of power and large quantities of new radium-like elements would be generated. Now, it appears almost certain that this could be achieved in the immediate future. Extremely powerful bombs of a new type may thus be constructed. Roosevelt took action immediately, creating programs that would eventually become the Manhattan Project. Scientists today are issuing similar warnings. AGI stands to revolutionize military technology to an extent unseen since the splitting of the atom. After all, AI doesn't need to be superhuman to cause serious problems for fragile democracies. Twitter rage bait operations aside, deepfake technology has already been used to flip the outcome of Slovakia's presidential election in favor of a suspiciously pro-Russian candidate. But once AI develops capabilities comparable to human experts, there's a critical tipping point at which a slew of sinister applications become unlocked, including complete population surveillance, superhuman hacking, biological weapon synthesis, and more. If democracies can get there first, they have leverage. They'll be able to understand the scope of the threat before any other agent and take the time to prepare technical guardrails, legal proposals, and negotiating strategies. But only if they have a head start and time to prepare. As we learned from the development of the atom bomb, the first country to achieve AGI will have unparalleled influence over the treaties and international institutions that will eventually govern the post-AGI future. China doesn't want to deal with AI-enabled bioterrorist organizations, and it's not in their interest to have their nuclear arsenal disarmed by hackers. Chinese leaders recognize these strategic risks, and the PLA has put forth a goal to intelligentize their warfighting capabilities on the backs of innovations in AI and quantum computing. While China's AI regulations have been quite restrained thus far, how can we be sure that restraint will continue in a future where China has the world's best AGI technology? Would there be any incentive for them to agree to constraints? And even if China will act reasonably, what about their allies in Iran, Russia, and North Korea? If the US really is at risk of leaking weaponizable AI secrets, perhaps our only choice is to lock down the labs. Chapter 3: Solutions. Susan came to the United States from China on a student visa. She was studying to earn a PhD in biomedical imaging, and in her second year, she took a trip home to China to see her family. When Susan came back from her vacation, American border security agents accused her of being a spy. Despite having zero evidence, they detained her at the airport and interrogated her for hours. Susan tried to explain that she was researching ultrasound technology, but nothing she said was good enough. The border guards canceled her visa and forced her to board a flight to Beijing against her will. When speaking anonymously to the press, Susan said, quote, "This has really, completely destroyed my life." Cracking down on spying is a noble goal, but Susan's tragic deportation demonstrates just how profoundly the government is failing in this department. Border security agents have not received any training about how to spot actual espionage. If they had, cases like this would not exist. Faced with the reality that America is bleeding technological secrets, they decided to take matters into their own hands, in the worst way possible. At least 20 PhD students, all of them young Chinese women, have been baselessly detained and deported this way. You can't help but wonder, would these border agents have deported Einstein back to Germany? The Manhattan Project only succeeded because of contributions of Russians, Germans, and Hungarians, who came to America because they wanted to help defeat the Nazis. Profiling harms America's reputation, drives away highly skilled immigrants, and accomplishes absolutely nothing. Because, newsflash, spies don't have to be Chinese nationals. If we choose to treat every Chinese PhD student as suspicious, we are guaranteed to overlook threats from homegrown defectors, Russian agents, Iranian proxies, and more. But if the labs themselves are secure, AI research would never make it to the border in the first place. So, what is to be done? The honor system is just not going to cut it here, but it's also not realistic to go from zero to Fort Knox levels of security overnight. Here's what a moderate amount of federal government involvement would look like. 1. Conduct polygraph testing on all employees involved with advanced AI research, regardless of whether they are a U.S. citizen or a foreign national. These interviews should include questions about personal motivations and values. The government's methods for evaluating the character of civil servants can provide an example. 2. Require financial background checks to ensure that no researcher is so desperate for cash that they consider selling out the future of democracy. 3. Provide official cover stories for researchers whose family members live in a foreign country, including fake details about the work they are doing in America. 4. Keep all devices on site. No phones in, no phones out. Some critics argue that stricter security requirements will slow down innovation and cost too much money. But if these measures are successful, they might actually save money over time. Catching tech thieves and prosecuting them is supremely expensive. And not to state the obvious here, but investigating espionage after the fact cannot untransfer stolen technology. We have a choice to make. Will America's politicians choose to sit back and watch as weaponizable innovations flow out of America's tech companies? Will our legislators choose to scapegoat the immigrants who are fighting so desperately to join Team America? Or will our politicians step up to the plate, reach across the aisle, and pony up the resources to create real, nuanced solutions? The way America chooses to compete in the AGI race will be a defining moment in the history of the nation. If the American political system cannot rise to the occasion in the face of existentially high stakes, then perhaps democracy doesn't deserve to survive, after all. Thanks for watching this ChinaTalk deep dive. If you enjoyed this video, check out Asianometry and Polymatter for similar content. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and join us on the ChinaTalk podcast for weekly interviews with leading experts. Until next time, stay curious.